Tarlin clears his throat. My lords, it is true that Qual is very fond of the defense of Vothis. I do not think we can entice him to directly attack the Baroness.
Of course not. If there is such rampant fear for Lady Sartha's power and prowess, then we are not actually hoping to. Instead, the hope is to allow us the opportunity to become his new lord instead. After all, if he so truly despises the woman, perhaps he will actually answer to the cold logic of reason.
We will, of course, take care of the Baroness ourselves, as it must be, as we would have it be. She has a lot to answer for, and we will make sure that she does. All we need is for the bad battle here to be as less of a battle and more of a fight.
Besides, on the off chance our plans do horribly go awry and Lady Sartha does bring low the entire house of Vytharia, then really Captain Tethaqual has lost nothing in the interchange.
Tarlin nods.
And if you, of course, still will wish to do what you must, you will have so much an easier time of ridding Vothis of enemies from within. She raises hand. This is, however, mute. We will not fail.
Tarlin seems to think. And then he says, well, you certainly have confidence, my lords. He smiles. I have said before that's Lady Sartha is a terrible opponent, and it is true. If she is to be challenged, I do hope you bring all the advantage you can.
Rilinid rotates his head towards Nathkir. Will there be any problem with this stratagem in preserving the lives of your fellows, Nathkir?
The spider clicks his mandibles and then says, it seems a fine plan. This Gisrael will go along.
Rilinid gives that sort of rakish smile.
Thank you.
As if he considers it a personal compliment, really. Let's straighten out the collar there a bit.
Oh, yes, of course.
Mm. Yes, quite, yes.
Tarlin then looks around. Then I suppose we need to start assembling some of the ballistae when we get closer.
Well, dear nuts. Yes, stay out of sight until, of course, and of course out of hearing range until my brother returns.
The tunnel is rather narrow, close to Vothis. We cannot travel too many in abreast, mistress. He bows towards Alauneari. The army will be rather slow to react to any urgent crisis, I'm afraid.
She looks at Rilinid.
Rilinid shrugs and says, that will not be a problem if the drawbridge is rendered permanently inoperable after it being lowered.
It should take more than a day to repair any damage, regardless.
Not in nods. It depends on the damage, but yes.
Prepare then to have our best and finest of each of our three groups of troops, and Miku, of course, in the front lines when we approach. They will not be able to see our number, as only the front lines will be visible in the tunnel. However, we wish these front lines to be as impressive as possible.
Tarlin nods. There is a rather wide opening before the drawbridge, matron. It is a killing field for the ballistae on the walls. The troops could line up in that area, although dangerous. It would make a more impressive display.
You know, make sure that we line up our ballistae as well, then.
He nods.
See, DDS, you should have been a siege mage.
Have some of this Gizral spread to the walls, she looks at Nethkir. In that way, they will not be entirely sure how many they are, as long as we have quite a few visible.
Nethkir nods. We can stay within the shadow, but move visibly. That should give a frightening effect.
Hopefully more so to them than to our own.
Nethkir gives a sound that's like a chuckle kind of thing.
A spider chuckling. Those are the arachnophobia.
Imagine if you will.
An intelligent spider, basically as big as you. Now.
Now it looks at you and chuckles.
Now look at me.
Back to the spider. The spider's made out of diamonds.
Diamond spider.
And then eat you. Damn it. Alright.
Alright.
Is there anything else, Team PC?
One thing, Jonas. The improved dark vision trait that some of us have. That does mean that we have, like, more vision range than the average drow, right?
Yes.
Like, how common is it for other drow to have, like, this better vision?
Consider the fact that anyone possessing traits is so fantastically rare at any rate. You're looking at sort of, like, unique, like, named, like, high-powered individuals.
Yeah, usually it's... It is, yeah, it's powerful individuals like major NPCs and things like that usually. Like normal people generally do not have those kinds of advantages. There might be like exceptions out there, but generally they don't.
So it would be possible to like observe the wall without being spotted because we're just still out of range.
Yes.
Especially while hiding. So, yeah. Okay.
Yes.
And then you could engage in your level of diplomacy of rolling out while firing arrows.
Exactly.
We've come to talk to the god cat.
Like, arg!
Just attach, like, strips of paper to each arrow with a message.
If you're reading this, you're already...
Dear Tethiqual.
We've come for your money.
How are you?
I will be counting down from 100.
Arrows.
100.
Each.
99. Each one in the chest of someone.
Yep.
Then just start skipping numbers with the arrows.
Oh, where this
are the arrows I've got? We should have installed lighting fixtures down the tunnel. Damn it.
Damn it.
Like we wouldn't have turned those off.
Floodlights.
You should have like a floodlight on the
lasers.
Yeah. Have like a fire elemental trapped in a lantern that's shining out there.
If they break it, it's their own fault.
Then we will gain the fire elemental's favor by freeing it from its prison and turning against those who had sought to shackle it.
I am Baron Emberglow. I will now guarantee 3 wishes.
Cool. First wish, grant Trislin a restored intellectual capacity. Second wish, best clothes ever. Third wish, need a penis
more
for
wishes.
Every gnome in Fastervall. The end.
It'd be great.
Practical
All right.
wishes.
Exactly, practical wishes. Very well, with that, then Nethkir will scurry off from the council to prepare his troops, and Trollin will head off to do things with Ballista and things, if no one stops them.
Not a problem.
Because we need a quad Ballista.
That's right.
Yes.
I'm not going to stop him. Rilnit's got his head in the game.
Yeah. He's preparing. He's like psyching himself.
I'm gonna cut a promo on these fools.
That's right. That's right.
Listen, Tether Quoll. Yeah. Lady Sata is nothing more than a single grain of sand in the Sahara Desert that is Rilinid madness.
Damn.
I win a performance all right. check.
Yeah. Exactly. Alright. In that case, the day before preparation, the day of preparation, before going to Vothis, so you can then copy your tokens and move to Vothis.
Woo!
Moving on us to the Vothis.
Here?
Yeah, very good.
Can I move here?
You're not allowed to be inside the tower, if that's what you were pointing
out. No, you can't be on the tower, sorry.
You got a favor from the planar merchant, didn't you? We joked about that, Manaki and I, of like having like the planar merchant just suddenly like appear with the tower and the garden.
Greetings.
Now that'll be 5,000 gold pieces.
Exactly. Well, you could probably make a deal.
Yeah, we'll give him like all these wonderful bodies, you know, of our captives.
You can have any body of Lady Sotha's personal guard that you can take.
Okay.
Even alive, just claim him.
All right, wonderful.
Matter of fact, we would even give him Lady Sotha herself. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, that'd be fine. I mean, I don't think she would enjoy that.
I mean, I'd love to torture, but why not give her the planar merchant?
Keep us the live specimen, please. Yeah. She'll live a couple hundred more years.
Suspended animation. You can ask her whatever question you'd like.
Was just standing there, yeah.
Alright, as you approach close to Vothis, I guess Rilinid then heads off.
Oh, absolutely. He's dressed in all of his appropriate, you know, his travel gear finery with, you know, his leather, you know, supple gloves over his finely manicured hands and la 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 la. Ready to look the prime and, you know, principal part as if someone who's just been traveling through the fucking Azathir, which, as a matter of fact, is not dishonest.
It's true.
And as for, you know, his attitude, you know, general mood, as you'll write on Facebook, you know, he's got this imperious saunter, you know, just the walk as if he fully expects whatever his mind wishes, you know, commanding, as any nobleborn very well would. And so rather imperiously, you know, just all on his own, you know, walking out of the shadows into the dim torchlight of, you know, fucking the Vothis wall, and just, you know, his fucking jaunty, you know, some sort of hum. Let's stroll, you know. And I'm here, the hood of the cow, you know, just a bit over.
All right. When he comes into basically sight range of the wall, there seems to be some movement up there as people notice him.
Oh, that's perfectly understandable. It's all right. They're expecting me.
as he gets close, someone shouts from up on the wall. Who goes there?
And it stops and sighs, as if, you know, this is like some sort of affront to him. And so he says, I am agent and cousin to Lady Sartha Sebastia, Baroness and your personal overlord, returned a day early from her agency she had commanded of me. And, you know, snaking forward, pulling out the pendant of House Sebastia and raising it to the wall. Do be so kind as to grant me entrance. Actually, first your name.
Warrior on the wall gives him the name. Like, I don't have a name, but
like there's some sort of rank, like a sergeant perhaps, or
yeah, he gives his name as basically sergeant something something.
Ah, sergeant something something. Yes, you.
The sergeant seemed to blink a bit, look down at Rilinid. Well, what's the past phrase?
Rilinid actually lowers his head. Sergeant, how long have you been on this job?
He looks around. A couple of years now.
Rilinid nods and says, yes, exactly what I thought. You, of course, here just as but a commoner riffraff, challenging a nobleborn of House Sevastia. Tell me, yes, the whole password passphrase. Yes, do keep in mind, I been away for a few months, and being dear cousin to Lady Sartha Sevastia, Baroness and your personal overlord, would you like to scream the very passphrase you would request of me, your superior, every time Gorval strikes you with his whip?
He shifts about a bit up there. Seems rather uncomfortable.
Or maybe you'll have me give you to the alchemist. Why, she is rather bereft of specimens to use for her personal designs, having been cut off from the Zyn for so long. Maybe you would enjoy her as well.
He seems to visibly swallow.
I mean, or obviously you could be stationed away a bit. Maybe the kobold camps where you could smell and hear the constant yipping of 100 draconic screeching fowl. Putrescent little humanoids who are our slaves. Perhaps you'd love to be stationed down there instead of overseeing the walls in defense of this fortress.
Shifts about.
Actually, no. Please do be considered, because there are two options here. One is you lower the gate and let me in, and he'll actually cast Vanish on himself. Two, I make my way in any way where you can't see me. I tell my dear cousin of your actions, Sergeant, and... well... that moat down below you will have wished you had fallen down it yourself in 4 years.
He seems visibly shaken at this point, and seems to sort of stammer a bit, and like he makes some sort of half motion, and then he shouts to the other one on the other side of the gate, basically, load a drawbridge.
Rilinid will dispel the vanish and just sort of peer, you know. Thank you, Sergeant. Your defense of Varthus is most admirable. And if you would like it, I am sure my dear cousin would love if your name were mentioned.
He nods, still, you know, seems quite shaken. The drawbridge cranks, they hear the cranking from the great wheel that sort of holds it up as it's slowly lowered down on the chains, and with a great thud strikes the stone on the other side of the chasm.
Rilinid will, pull the pendant back into his person, and continuing this jaunty saunter, a man who knows his position is above everyone else around him, we'll cross through the threshold.
As soon as he is in, the sergeant atop the wall makes the sign again, and the drawbridge slowly starts to erase. He will, you see him when Rilin gets around, you will see the sergeant, come down from the wall and come around to basically meet him. He will, salute and say, "My lord, then, I, Lady Sartha is currently in her chambers atop the tower, I believe."
Rilinid and nods and waves and says, yes, I am a day early, and not even I am foolish enough to appear before my cousin. Sort of like that, just like sort of to trail off, like even there's fear there.
Yeah, the sergeant sort of nods a little bit. she's a bit upset of late, my lord.
Indeed, she used to be so. But have you ever been to Tarisia?
The sergeant shakes his head. No, my lord. I came by the old trade route.
Ah, yes, Tarisia is a sight.
of beyond splendor, beyond anything I could even describe to you. This is such a glorious place, and House Sevastia, truly the mightiest of all, has worn down on her greatly that we have been exiled to this place. But, Sergeant, with those who are so perceptive and cunning as you on our walls, truly we are hoping to make a great difference here.
Yeah, he smiles slightly and nods and salutes. Thank you, my lord.
I forgive you for your doubt, and as a matter of fact, I understand that my actions can come across as disconcerting, and indeed it would do well to have seen yourself in the sight of someone with such grandeur over yours. So,
and Rilinid will actually sort of pull out of his pocket and fuss out 5 gold pieces.
The caravans are so delayed, and they do come but once a year, but I do believe, if nothing else, you can throw this on a game of chance, see if you can win more from the others.
Yeah, he smiles at Rilinid. My lord, actually, the caravans, they were just here.
Rilinid blinks. Have I been so far away? Damn.
He nods. But my lord, the stores are currently filled.
Excellent.
Maybe I am sure your he's like stops himself. The great Lady Sartha will be most pleased of your return. I am sure she will bequeath you anything you would like from the stores, my lord.
Indeed, in that case, and he will hand over the 5 gold pieces, take this, for you are the bearer of most fortunate news.
The drum warrior smiles and salutes again. My lord, thank you. Thank you. You are most generous. And he sort of bows deeply before Rilinid.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Rilinid's going to crack his bones and just sort of take a look like at the sights that he can see now that he has walked through like the drawbridge of Varthas. Who's he got a side angle on?
Well, looking around, he doesn't see. First of all, he doesn't really see any grand movements in and out of the keep itself.
Of course not.
There might be some shadows flickering about up here, but it's really too far to make out exactly what might be happening up there. Although he might guess, the garden, as it were, is deserted. Although, you know, the barbs certainly make it a place that no one really visits. On the side of the wall, he does notice that up here seems to be basically two drow. One of them seems to be a guard, the other one seems to be some sort of engineer that is sort of tending to the ballistae. There seems to be a similar arrangement over here. And then you have the sergeant who stood guard, like right next to the through drawbridge. The mechanism for rising and lowering the drawbridge seems to be on this place over here,
okay.
This sort of platform up here. He also notices the gate guard post, which is located in this like round half tower thing. The entrance is on the backside here.
And these two have, like, direct sight lines to each other?
Yes.
Okay. So the drawbridge mechanism is in line of sight to, say, both towers?
Yeah, they are. If someone stands by the drawbridge mechanism, both of the guard posts here can see them.
Okay. Okay, that's workable. Well, with the sergeant having scurried off, Rilinid will actually make his way up to this, you know, tower. By all means, he is certainly a nobleborn, a part of House Sevastia itself. It is certainly his right to ensure the defense of this fortress.
Mm-hmm, clearly, yes. Yeah, he can certainly make his way up there. The guard seems a little bit surprised when he, you know, starts to climb the stairs to get up. But he, you know, stands attention and salutes, and the engineer quickly does the same. The soldier says, "My lord."
Rilinid just sort of bends his head and says, "How long have you two been at your post?"
"We have been here for 5 hours, my lord."
Rilinid says, "You know, I have heard the most delightful news. The sergeant I just spoke with said that the caravan had but arrived a short time ago, and the stores of Varthus were full to the brim."
The soldier nods, "Yes, my lord. It was great luck. There seems to have been some trouble down the great jumping off point, and caravans has been rather slow of late."
Rilinid nods, "Indeed, that is part of what has depressed my cousin so, being exiled so far from home, and the accoutrements therefore thereof, but..." And Rilinid begins fishing in his pockets, and like gold pieces just like slowly cling to his hand. "You know, I am in such a generous mood, and I am looking to celebrate the occasion, and by all means indeed, it would be absolutely delightful to have a great taste of insert such and such popular drow wine."
Sure.
"And if such could be accrued along with a wonderful bit of some of the delightful tastes of that caravan, why, I would be willing to, even in my magnanimity, if two individuals, two aspiring, intelligent, ambitious individuals were willing to go like yourselves, while a noble-born oversaw the wall, not only would I be willing to put in a good name for my cousin, but perhaps even 5 gold pieces each, if the two would be so willing to just fetch this in delicious for me."
They do look somewhat intrigued. Roll a bluff check.
Sure, I can do that. Do 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 24. That was a roll of 3, by the way.
Let's see what this guy has.
I'm offering money. Shinies.
It's true. Yeah. He seems to consider it, and then like he slowly nods and says, "Yes, that sounds wonderful, my lord, but Captain Quall has put much of the stores on the lock and key, you see."
Oh, Rilinid frowns. Oh. And then, you know, he slowly begins putting the gold pieces back in the bag with... I understand, obviously.
But my well, it's still guarded by, well, by my mistress, my lord. I am sure if we were to include her in this delicious endeavor, she could be persuaded to perhaps let go of some of the wares my lord wished.
Rilinid then quickly said, "Are you so willing to speak with the mistress yourself? You volunteered your own name?"
Well, the drow warrior shrugs. You misunderstand me, my lord. I did not mean the dread baroness. I meant my mistress as my lover.
Ah, Rilinid nods. "I see. And who might she be?"
He shrugs. "She is a... She came a couple of years back. And she has the most wonderful fantasies." He sort of drifts off like a dreamy state almost. Seemingly consider all the fantastic fantasies.
Rilinid nods and says, "I understand. You're asking for more." And then, you know, gold pieces start clinking back out of his bag into the hand. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How much does Tetherqual pay you? What are your wages?
The drowned warrior shrugs. It's usually 5 gold a week.
Indeed, so you've made quite a windfall here for yourself and your mistress. Did 10 whole gold pieces, 5 for each of you?
He nods. That is very generous, my lord. He looks at the gold. He nods. I will. We will fetch it immediately.
Good.
Like looks at his engineering friend, who seems like just blink to all of this, and seemingly starting to say something.
Rilinid just sort of like looks like, "Oh,
You don't. Oh, you would tell my cousin, wouldn't you?
And just sort of like that menacing step forward towards the engineer.
The engineer looks momentarily very surprised and then sort of backs off and shakes his head. No, of course not, my lord. If you are part of the Sevastia family, the goods are already yours as far as I'm concerned. Oh, he smiles.
You would seem as you would ruin my cousin's personal reflection herself and her own meditation to bring spoil to this whole affair.
Like another step forward.
She said, no, my lord, absolutely not.
Good. Why don't you go along with my dear fellow here and help secure it? Who knows? Maybe we could actually find someone suitable for you. You seem the sort who needs to be controlled.
Yeah. Swallows and like nods shakingly. And the warrior basically hisses something at him, basically to the effect of shut up and come along.
Don't cock block me, man. Just go.
Exactly.